Convention Center. This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won.
Good morning. Welcome to Guardian Radio 96.9. Voice already, it's Leyvon Miller. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for letting me join you. I don't know what it is you do at 11 o'clock, but whatever it is that you do, I'm happy that you do that do and that you're doing that do with me. I'm happy to see that there's finally been a communication from the Cabinet Office of the Bahamas indicating the lowering of the national flag in honor of A.D. Hanna. I know that we are all caught up in the crazy of the election. I know that we are all caught up in our sport-like fascination with our political organizations. And I know that in the middle of all of this hoo-ha, it's very easy for us to forget that there is still a nation here that is worth fighting for, and that there are men and women that have fought and that have given some of them their all. Some of them have given their all in other aspects. To all the men and women that have, though, all of the men and women that have countries we know to be the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, we are forever and eternally grateful to you for your sacrifices. We understand that without you, there could be no Bahamas. Nationhood is what it is, and it is largely because of your contributions. And so after I drove here this morning, I had the opportunity to drive along the corridor where the National Security Headquarters is. I also had the opportunity to drive past the Attorney General's office. And I had an opportunity to drive past the police college, and all of the flags are at half mast. I'm so pleased. I don't recall what was happening at the Ministry of Education, but the flags are down, and I appreciate that. I think these are the kinds of things that coin what development looks like, how you know when you take things seriously, when you ensure that the trappings of a developed nation are things you do not overlook. So to the former Governor General, posthumously, we thank you, sir, for the work that you've done. And I thought that I would do this tribute for him this morning, just so that we remember why. For those of you that have forgotten why, as you travel along the busy corridors today and you see the lowered jack, the national flag, that is, and you see all of the other lowered flags, I do not want you to be confused. I want you to be sure that it is in tribute to a man that is a man who is a man among men. His name is Arthur Dion Hanna, the Most Honorable, His Excellency, former Governor General of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. All right? And so I thought I'd get that out of the way this morning. Again, we are a grateful and a sad nation, and in a short course, we will have him laid to his eternal resting place to rise in glory day. All right, so that's how I'm opening my show this morning. But of course, you know, politics is in the air. So we've got a little bit of politics going on. I want to take a short break. Let me take a short break so that we can shift gears. When we get back, I'm talking about the chairman of the Free National Movement. I tell you, I believe they on bad prescription medication over there, you know. That's the only way to describe this behavior. Don't go anywhere. It's Leyvon Miller. You're on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. I'm Unleashed on your radio. We'll be back.
Hello, Bahamas. My name is Dr. Dwayne Sands. I was born and raised in Centerville, in the heart of the valley, Nassau, Bahamas. I'm a proud Bahamian. I've been fortunate to represent the great people of Elizabeth for the last 5 years. It has always been to serve my country, and I have been involved in the political process on the front line since 2009. I am very, very proud of the support of my family who have been with me from the beginning and who are still with me to this day. In particular, my wife, Larika, and all of my children. And actually, there's quite a few of them. I'm actually a cardiovascular surgeon. What that means is I take on the sickest people with the biggest problems every day. And so for me, the political process to deal with the challenges facing our country is pretty much par for the course. It's what I do every day. I am happy to be a part of the great team of the Free National Movement under the leadership of Dr. Hubert Minnis. We are indeed Elizabeth Strong.
This has been a paid political announcement by the FNM candidate for Elizabeth.
Hey, did you find the show interesting? Do you want to be a part of the conversation? Sponsor Unleashed today. Call 302-2304 or 302-2375 to see which package is right for you. Join Leyvon Miller as he ignites the passion of the next generation by bridging the gap with engaging conversations and innovative ideas. Take action and sponsor Unleashed today at 302-2304 or 302-2375 and be unleashed.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Welcome back. Thank you for staying with me. It's Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. It's your station for fresh news. Say that this show is being sponsored by Dr. Dwayne Sands, your Elizabeth Estates candidate for the Free National Movement. Before I get past that, though, let me also say a special shout out. You heard me call her name last week. I'm calling her name again this week to D, right? Mama D. She has a birthday today. I think they say she's 26. I don't know. She doesn't look a day over 25, though. And so wherever she is, I'm sure her kids and grandchildren are all doing a wonderful job making her feel very special. And I want to send my and convey my congratulations to her as well. So wherever you are, cake cutting and ice cream eating, please have a good day because you only turn 26 one time, all right? And so today, that's my shout out. And to the kids, you all make sure you all take her to spin the block. You know, she like to ride around in air condition and things like that. All right, so I want to let you all hear from the chairman of the Free National Movement, who I have alluded to along that has lost his mind, all right? I think Carl Kalmer is a special replica of why everybody cannot be chairman. And then, to his credit, maybe we have had the wrong idea of chairmanship in our culture. Typically, chairmen of political organizations in the Bahamas largely are the spokespersons. If you remember the days of Big Bad Brad, you would remember that he was a political juggernaut, if you will, a political Muhammad Ali or Boston Blackie, to keep it local. Somebody that use of the English language in his attacks against the Free National Movement. You would also remember people like the Darren Cashes that have been, very articulate in the pronouncements made on behalf of the Free National Movement and things of the law of the sort, right? Interestingly enough, that's technically not the real job of the chairman, right? The real job of the chairman is to take care of the executive function of the party, you know, to make sure the dues are paid, the money is paid, the light is on, the building is painted, you know, the machinery is ready, you know, that kind of stuff. That's actually the job of the chairman. But all things taken into consideration, it is reasonable to assume that if you're going to accept the job of chairman in a particular climate, see, you've always got to learn the culture of the people. And so while I understand, again, to Carl's credit, that he may be, brilliant executively, y'all should have then run him through one speech course by now or something, because how can a chairman of a political organization who largely needs numbers to win would spin around and turn his political cannon on the largest segment of the population or the representatives of the largest segment of the population. This isn't a minority group that he attacked. He isn't talking about the Haitian Bahamians. He isn't talking about the Philippine Bahamians. He isn't talking about white men, who I believe is a minority around, you know. This guy, right, the chairman, for whatever the reason, thought it fitting to attack the unions. I don't understand the as a matter of fact, and I'm going to let you hear the clip. He surmises that the actions of the union amount to nothing more than a PLP tactic. The PLP used the unions to come to power in 67, and so they've been engaging this tactic ever since. Well, what a time to be alive in God's holy kingdom. So are you then suggesting to me that in 92, 97, and 07, and then again in 17, is your suggestion to me then, Mr. Chairman, that the unions still were tools of the Progressive Liberal Party? Because I remember the Progressive Liberal Party being obliterated in those years. You see, you can't say stupid things. You follow where I'm going with this, Ali? Like, you have to sit. If you're going to be in public life, here's a recommendation I give to you. Practice talking to yourself often. Because sometimes your brain isn't smart enough to tell you that the thing you're thinking about is stupid. So you need your air to hear it. And when your air hears it, your air tells your brain what your mouth said, and then you catch your brain saying, that's stupid. And now you can begin to think about something else. If you're going to be in public life, practice saying some of this stuff to yourself in the mirror. Not only so you could see how stupid you sound, but you could see how stupid you would look to the rest of us if you actually said it with a camera. And last but not least on my list of things to recommend to people in public life is find someone who is comfortable with calling you stupid when you say stupid things. And you make sure you don't do a single thing unless you call them. And so the conversation should go like this. Hey, Ali, I want to tell you this. What's going on, Leyvon? Man, I believe these unions is nothing more than a tool of the PLP. And Allenton, my friend, should say, you ain't say that on air where people could hear you. No. I didn't say that. I was just thinking. Boy, please don't go there and say that stupidness. You need that in public life. Because your brain isn't capable of telling you when you sound stupid. Your brain just doesn't know. So in your head, you sound like a genius. When all along, you sound pretty stupid to the rest of us. Okay? And that's just my thesis on it. I'll give you an opportunity to hear the chairman. Maybe you didn't. Maybe you did. My assessment is that I thought, number one would surely be Pakeisha Barker, Edgecombe. I regret to inform you that she has been eclipsed on the stupid things to say o meter. Here is the chairman of the Free National Movement.
Recent union unrest, nothing more than a PLP tactic designed to power. His comments come days after Bahamas Power and Light workers walked off the job and as the Public Hospitals Authority experienced the days-long sick out. The Bahamas Union of Teachers has also threatened industrial action.
That is a tactic of the PLP. They always, they came to power on the backs of the trade union movement back in 67. It was the unions that shut down the country. They used the unions to gain power. And then when they gained power through the unions, they kicked them on the side.
On Friday, Trade Union Congress President Obi Ferguson said he's advising his members to vote their interests and slam the Minnesota administration's treatment of the workers. However, Colmer says he believes union members will make the right choice when it's time to mark their X.
I believe union leaders and the members of the union will realize that, hey, at the end of the day, when they go into the box, the ballot box, they will realize we have the PLP and we have the FNM. And when they look at both of them and they look at the leadership, they look at how the team has been working together and how the teams have been fulfilling and bringing the country through these rough times, there's no comparison.
When asked if the party is concerned about the state of labor in the country, Colmer said he believes the union leaders will not be used.
I feel that the union leaders would sit down and understand that, hey, they will not be used this time by the PLP to gain the advantage going forward.
Right, but I mean by concern that you don't think it'll impact you at the polls?
I believe that Bahamian people at the end of the day will understand that the best party, the best leadership team to run this country is the FNM.
Reporting for Our News, I'm Berthany McDermott.
Everything is changing in your favorite hardware and home improvement store.
The chairman of the Free National Movement, who's there? I don't think that the leaders of the unions will allow the PLP to use them. Problem, stupid thing number one. There, Mr. Chairman of the Free National Movement. Are you aware that it was a leader of a union that led the protest that you just deemed a PLP tactic? Are you also aware that the president of the teachers' union is kicking and screaming and rolling over, screaming bloody murder in the middle of the street almost every single day because she has a minister that she claims refuses to allow people that are senior civil servants to do their jobs in a way that is effective and in accordance with general orders? That they are transferring her teachers without any prior notice? Are you aware that the president of the teachers' union, it was alleged to have been an FNM, if my memory isn't fuzzy, is saying that she has very little idea of what will be the case when children go back to school? Are you aware that the president of the teachers' union is also saying that they have drawn up, I think it is a 32-page document, and presented it to the Ministry of Education without absolutely any response whatsoever by the ministry? Are you aware that Adrian Gibson and the Water and Sewage Corporation Union been over there and the only thing they ain't doing is swinging bats at each other, and that been going on for almost 3 years? You see why you can't just like say stupid things? And if you say something stupid, you have to play the game. When you say something stupid, you have to say the Latin word. Ova tenas iam. And you have to read it. When you say stupid things, that's what has to happen. You have to play the Latin game. And so you say to me, you don't think, stupid thing number two, you don't think the Bahamian people will be affected, or the Bahamian voter will be affected by the movement of the unions. And I feel like a grade 3 student, because it is at this point that I would raise my hand and say, ooh, 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 me teacher, me teacher, me. Well, the people in the union, they Canadians, eh? Hungarians, maybe? Barcelonians? Where do you imagine the people from the union, from? Are they not? oh, God. What is even worse is if they are involved in unions, I am willing to bet my wife in a swingers bar that they are possibly very engaged in politics and the processes of politics, which means you sure they registered to vote. Stupid thing number three. But this would happen when you let the man run and nobody can test him because he was the dude the leader wanted. And now this what you got. Carl Colmer, ladies and gentlemen. Let us all stand to our feet and give him a round of applause. That's what I want to say. 3-2-3-6-2. 325-4316-325-4259. I also want to say you can call me and cuss me. I don't have a problem with that. I'm pretty cool with that. You can text me 422-4796. That is my text line. Let me get a couple of these text messages. Carl Kulmer, you got to play the Latin game. Look in the mirror and say the word. You've got to do it. I'm telling you, that is the rule. When you say stupid things out loud, you have to play the Latin game. Let me read a couple of these text messages. This one says, Leyvon, you believe these people, they fly in the flag at half star 3 weeks after Mr. Hanna died. I checked it out for context. In the U.S., flags fly at half star for 30 days after the death of a president, 10 days for a vice president. We must have similar protocols. 3 weeks pass. What a disgrace. This man can't do anything right. Three bungled messages to dissolve parliament. Pakisha Parker say, when you go to the poll, the one thing she wants you to consider is the efficacy of the handling of affairs by this administration. I want you to think about this. I'm not a very hard sell, you know. I have concluded what I need to be promised, and I intend to tell you about it, right? We're going to talk about that a little bit more. So I figured it out. I know what I want. I know what I want a political party to promise me in order to get my vote. And I also want you to tell me what is it that you want. Like, what is it that when you think about political parties, what they offer, what they say is their, because they don't have manifestos this go around. So I guess their talking points or their card. The PLP fit its entire economic plan on a card, and then they fit their entire COVID plan on a card as well. So maybe when they bring you the card, I need you all to prepare a third card, because now I think I know what I want. And when I tell you all, this is going to be pretty easy to deliver. So I know what I want, and I need you all to deliver it. And any party that promises it, I'm voting for them. All right? Just promise it to me. You don't have to deliver it. Just promise it, and I'm voting for you. Let's get another text message in. This one says, Mr. Miller, the PLP and FNM display their thousands of red. Notice, they all stands on the green lawn, and that is for the DNA. Hip, hip, hip. Hooray. Do you know what the DNA is like to be, what I think about it? Have you ever been to court, and the judge say, Sheila Thompson? And then the little guy come out and say, Sheila Thompson? Because he got to call your name slow. Sheila Thompson. Sheila Thompson. No appearance of Sheila Thompson, Your Worship. Yeah, y'all might suggest Senator Warren of arrest for the DNA because they have not appeared. This one says, and I'm not even on social media. And that's it. I don't understand how a party that had 10 years of practicing social media campaigning, right? Like, I feel like the pandemic is, I mean, Jesus get us to y'all. Y'all had 10 years to campaign on social media, right? And you know, and how to troll, because you know y'all trolls working very well. Matter of fact, y'all should put them in charge of the campaign. And now y'all are being outrun in the social media campaign. I can't get it. I just don't get it. Anyway, this one here says, hi, you cannot have the FNM chairman more articulate than the leader of the party. Carl Kulmer is a far drop. I mean, think about it. Darren Cash used to be the chairman of that party, you know. Michael Pintard. You know, I listened to Darren Cash. I said to myself, wow, this man is intelligent. I just want to listen to him all day. He has a soothing voice. He talks and I understand everything he says. I don't know what's happening with Carl Kulmer, man. God save the Queen. Thanks, Mr. Miller. I also pay tribute and appreciate the great Bahamian leader and former GG, the Honorable Lady Hannah, so very much. And finally, flag is lowered. I hope he and other great are celebrated in an established museum where all Bahamian and youth in school, residents and visitors can enjoy. Maybe former Shirley Street Theater is a good location. New next government should do this. What do you think? It's possible. This one here says the PLP is more labor friendly. The FNM chairman said the PLP set up the unions to strike, but he forgot the teachers union carried Fitzgerald to war. And on another note, I don't really know if the Free National Movement could talk about any grouping of people uprising now. You know, we remember the black movement, you know. Do I call their name? I can call the name of the movement. I won't ever call the name of the guy, not publicly. It's not worth the utterance of my breath. Let's take a call, Alan. Good morning, caller. You're on. Not there? Good. Let's read another one. This one says, man, Leyvon, the chairman of the FNM, any of those things you mentioned. You wasted your time telling him these things, buddy, because Carl Kalba always saying dumbness. But you, I don't mind if you say dumbness, you know. You say dumb things when you're around your friends. Like, when you go to your friend's backyard grill, you could say stupid things there. That's fine. Like, you could just, because they know you're stupid. So if you say stupid things, they feel comfortable. You cause shock and awe, though, when we give you public offices and then you say stupid things with the camera looking at you. That's when it's kind of weird. And I don't know, like, they don't make you all practice these things, eh? You just can get up and say anything you want to on TV? This is incredible. Let's take the call, Ali. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there?
Hello, you can hear me?
Loud and clear.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Miller, I think, let me start off by saying, Rule Britannia, man, send the letter. Send the letter to the...
Listen to me, when I said that on air the other day, I had someone message me immediately after the show and say, please don't fool with that. You let Elizabeth Regina stay right where it is, and James, we could be all right. That's what they tell me. But you say go write the letter.
Send the letter, buddy.
Okay, buddy, no problem.
That's enough. Because you rule said it, we can have people like Carl Kalba.
My God, man, don't say it loud.
Bella, I was campaigning over the hill, uptown, one night, and this boy, I know the boy from the community. He come down the road saying, I in South Beach.
Yeah.
I in South
Beach. I for Tanya.
I for Tanya. And yeah. I was like, wait, hey, I got beat in for another body. I don't like the fact that he said it, but I like the jingle.
Listen to me. That was the best slogan in the history of Bahamian slogans.
Ever.
In the history. I don't want anything else. In 2000, and what was it, two? The one thing, if you lived in South Beach, you knew one thing was certain and sure. You was FNM, you was in South Beach, and you was for Tanya. You didn't need to know anything else?
Oh, yeah, man. I hear people start saying, I is Christian. I is this life for Jesus. And you know, that Tanya slogan.
Yeah, Tanya, that was good.
That was catchy, man.
That
listen,
was good. Mm-hmm.
I oftentimes tell my children when I hear them say stuff, what I know here, right, what sound like you say stupid, don't let nobody else hear you say that, okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
What you mean? Don't say that outside of this room.
Only say this to your friends. Don't say this to no one else.
No one else, because you can look stupid.
And because people will wonder, who I raising?
And they're going to take your time to learn. They're going to take with you to see him no more, my friend.
Yeah, yeah.
But the FNM had this man bridled for about 2 years.
Carl, see. See, I won't repeat it because... So, let me tell you what else I realized. You know, sometimes your brain don't hear your voice say things. So,
I bet you on that one.
So you have to actually hear someone else say it.
You got
to
hear it.
Right. Here's what Carl Kalma said. The Bahamian voter will not be swayed. He's confident. Be swayed by the union. Could you please tell me where are the union members from?
The Bahamian voter.
Uganda, maybe?
But he really think those nurses and doctors, whatever, the sickle strike or whatever they call it.
That the PLP send them out there?
Yeah, that they do it because of the PLP? Could it have anything to do with the minister driver and his assistant getting money and
It could have nothing to do with that. Absolutely possible. No way ever could it have ever had anything to do with that. Under no circumstance.
I think Mr. Goldman just the party. Bridle them a bit.
You just say they had him on a 2-year bridal? More bridal than that?
Yeah, they have to bridal him for 2 more weeks. before I go to just say, I agree with you yesterday when you said the candidate for South Andres, he could have stayed in the race. We only got 3 weeks.
Right. Unless you get shooting your head, I can't figure out what else could be wrong with you.
You get the domination thing. And you send your little groups of fives, only fives.
Yeah.
And when they say where the candidates, think, man, the candidate would love to
talk. He's honest way to see you. Give him your name and give him your email address.
Yeah, the confident choice say only five of us.
Yep.
He can try to get to you, but in a short time, if we don't get to you, just know that we appreciate your support. But I just run the clock out.
And the truth is, right, South Andres only got about 18 people in it. So
you run the clock out,
yeah,
that's all.
Yeah, we could always double
it. The president, deputy prime minister, run the clock out because he was sick last election.
Well,
he made it in, so I don't know why 3 weeks in you just dropped the ball like that?
I don't know. Well,
thank you for taking my call. I'm looking forward to hear your list of demands or promises made.
This could be easy. Man, you gotta could do this. Appreciate you, caller. That's my music. I'm going to a break. 323-622-3253-1-6-325-4259. I'm on.
Hello, Bahamas. My name is Dr. Dwayne Sands. I was born and raised in Centerville, in the heart of the valley, Nassau, Bahamas. I'm a proud Bahamian. I've been fortunate to represent the great people of Elizabeth for the last 5 years. It has always been my dream to serve my country, and I have been involved in the political process on the front line since 2009. I am very, very proud of the support of my family, who have been with me from the beginning and who are still with me to this day. In particular, my wife, Larika, and all of my children. And actually, there's quite a few of them. I'm actually a cardiovascular surgeon. What that means is I take on the sickest people with the biggest problems every day. And so for me, the political process to deal with the challenges facing our country is pretty much par for the course. It's what I do every day. I am happy to be a part of the great team of the Free National Movement under the leadership of Dr. Hubert Minnis. We are indeed Elizabeth Strong.
This has been a paid political announcement by the FNM candidate for Elizabeth.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure.
The heavens, no man, no weapon formed against.
Welcome back. It's Leyvon on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My producer's so serious. Y'all just be saying I cut the people on the phone, right? See, my producer just cut me. So, what you think with y'all? Y'all think y'all special? Anyway, let me see if I can knock on a couple of these text messages. I understand that it was supposed to have been a call through, but I think we're gonna have to carry that into tomorrow because I wasn't aware that that was happening. But, let's see. This here says, I'm going to need the Freedom of Information Act ASAP. Good morning, Leyvon. I thought last night a period of mourning was announced for former AG, Arthur Hannah starting today through Thursday. However, I noticed the Bahamian flag is still flown at full staff in Grand Bahama. Oh, God. Well, they kind of got it right here. So let's take this call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Did they get it right? Good morning.
Hey, what's going on, Papa?
Then cool. Tell me something. Oh, they didn't get it right when they didn't. Do it half more.
Well, you cannot put the flags at half mast. The only people that get to decide that is the cabinet office of the Bahamas, right?
Uh-huh. So they fall down.
I don't know what take them 3 weeks, but the communication came out 3 weeks later.
Oh boy, so sad.
Yeah.
It's so sad. Hey, listen. You hear the news where the, I think his name is King, the, what you call it, commissioner?
The Commodore, yes, I have heard.
What you think about what he say, and what you think about the part where, paraphrasing, where he say, your officers must remember what it is, why you take up that job, like to serve and protect.
I will tell you this, and this has always been my view on it. I don't know the relationship between Commodores and Commodores former, right?
Yes.
What I would say is, in many instances, I think that Commodores should actually talk to former Commodores, right?
Uh-huh.
Because a lot of them are no longer commanders. And so they understand when you are a commander, you have to be a forceful, probing human being. So there's no emotion involved in that, right?
Uh-huh.
Commanders command. That is what Cliff Scavalla says all the time. And sometimes you get caught up in the stratosphere of being a military commander that you do not consider certain things, the human capital, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay, because it sounds like he's really telling them they need to make a...
He's being a commander. He's doing, and I find no fault with that. He's doing what it is commanders do, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think it is in times like these, though, where you have to actually possibly call in civilian talent. Because you need someone that isn't a commander to speak to them, or to so that there is more attention paid to the human capital. The commander of Defense Force said that having vessels not able to save national security, those are his words, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, firing the whole force is also a threat to national security.
Yeah, that too.
You see what I'm saying? And so I believe he's going to have to practice a wonderful little saunter across this issue.
You need to bring in like Simeon Hall or a psychologist, like what the guy name, I forget.
Well, I don't know, but what he can do is find out who is it that they trust. Figure out who is popular and trusted among your men that isn't a commander, and so he has no vested interest in the force's interest. You see what I'm saying?
So you think they have to take the vaccine if he really
I want to say publicly, I heard him state that they agree an attestation upon entering the force, right? I signed the paper 17 years ago, so I don't remember the exact language, but I do remember agreeing to be vaccinated.
Okay.
Where I think the difficulty comes in is
this particular vaccine.
Yeah, and there may be a bit of a challenge there.
Yeah, this one we have. Hey, one last thing.
Yeah.
Listen to a lot of news in the Caribbean and around the world. In Jamaica, mm-hmm. they use in the what do they see? What you
the Pfizer?
What these people in the community is. What that profession is? What you do now?
I do many professions. Tell me what it is that they do.
You know, like affidavits and different things and stuff like that?
Oh, justice of the peace, notaries,
yeah. Yeah. Listen, in Jamaica, right, mm-hmm. they're using the justice of the peace stem to do many things. So I was saying, like in this country, maybe you could bring us up to date. What is the role of justice of the peace? Like what do they really do? What do they supposed to do in the community? I listen, in Jamaica, they're using them to talk to people in the community to encourage them to take the vaccine. I know you mightn't be down, me and you mightn't be down, and some people mightn't be down with it, but maybe one of these days you can let us know what's the role of the justice of peace in our country, the Bahamas.
No problem.
Our peace in the country. Keep up the good work, everyone.
No problem. Section 5 of the Magistrates Act is where justices of the peace get their powers from. You could, when you get an opportunity, have somebody look it up for you, and that'll outline all of the powers of the justice of the peace. I apparently have is the call there? Let's go to it. Good morning. Is he there?
Yes. Good morning, Leyvon Miller.
Hey, Robert.
Well, you really, JP?
If I am. I've been a justice of the peace since 2018.
Carl Bell signed up on that?
No, I think it was Allison Maynard Gibson, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, no. I applied 10 years earlier, though.
Are you younger than this?
Yeah, I became a JP at the age of, how old am I now? 34.
Okay. You're doing thanks. You do a good job.
Be honest, my
best. Fair and decent. Anyhow, the U.S. Defense Force, I mean, Defense Secretary, Lloyd Austin,
mm-hmm.
he wants every military to be vaccinated. But he had to push that Biden.
Mm.
That Biden call.
Mm.
But it's up to him, he say. He'll have all his men vaccinated. Every living, breathing American who in the armed forces.
Again, my advice to commanders are, in some instances, you need a consultant, not a commander. I'm going to a break. Let's go to a break. It's Leyvon Miller. I'm on your radio. I'll be back right after this break. Welcome back. Thank you for staying with me. I have on the phone line Mr. Zane Lightbourne, the Progressive Liberal Party's candidate for Yamacraw, is it? He's on with me. Good morning, Mr. Lightbourne. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Miller. How are you?
I am well. I'm well. I'm very well. You sound very very strong and sprightly. How is the Gambian drill?
Well, thanks for having me. The campaign is going very well.
Mm-hmm.
Very well. The response on the ground has been excellent. And I feel a new day coming.
You feel a new day coming. Well, tell us, Mr. Leyvon, what exactly are we to expect in a new day? I see some people are having a small bit of a challenge with that actual slogan. But what do you imagine people ought to look for with the dawn of a new day?
What the Bahamas need right now is transformational changes in everything that we do.
Mm-hmm.
Our economy, our education, our healthcare system. The country, it seemed to be crumbling around us.
Mm-hmm.
And leadership seemed to be lost in what should be done in response to all of these ills.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, the PLP got to work a very long time ago, since our defeat, and rebuilt, not only with dynamic leaders as a part of a dynamic team headed by Mr. Philip Brave, who is an awesome and visionary leader, but we put together a number of plans, which includes a very excellent, robust economic plan, a bold economic plan that would bring immediate relief to our citizens in this country.
Mm-hmm.
And so a new day addresses these ills that we are experiencing and gives people not only hope, but buy-in and an opportunity for them to be invested into our country, which is what young people are calling for,
mm-hmm.
and also relief in terms of how far their economics, their monies can go.
Mm-hmm.
They want to be able to stretch their dollar. They want employment. They want education to be not only efficient, but effective and reaching all of the students that the Act gives us responsibility and the government responsibility to reach. Our country has to be turned around direction, and therefore we need a new day.
Now, you said that we need transformational change. I want to just give you some of the facts, right? Some of the facts is that this is possibly going to be a greater economic crisis period, even greater than the one in 2008. Small developing island nations are going to grapple for at least 3 years with budgetary constraints, borrowing constraints, just flat out developmental constraints due to the hardship in the economy. There are several ways to go about creating or generating revenue, but let us face it, if the people have no money, how do we get money from them in order to have this kind of transformational change that you're talking about?
Well, the people are holding on to their funds because they were surprised by a tax increase that happened immediately after this government came into power.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to address that, first of all, by decreasing the value-added tax to 10%.
Mm-hmm.
Persons looking for jobs and opportunities, we have addressed that in a number of ways where we expand our economy, not only to focus on tourism, but in all of the economies that would have been spelled out, not only with labor leaders and other political leaders, and also the Chamber of Commerce and the employers in this country, in a national development plan, which was put in place by minds that want to see a development of a country go forward beyond administrations. We are going to rescue this economy by putting those things in place, giving people opportunities, and definitely having leadership and visionary leadership at the helm.
Now, you talk about this reduction in VAT to 10%. I want to say personally, Mr. Leyvon, that if I were something that gave me some concern. And the reason for me is, in my mind, when I think about it, I just don't understand how is it to work. I think I've seen in the plan it says that you want to reduce it to 10% and then review it after 1 year. But, there was a lot of money implemented in value-added tax being introduced. There was even more money invested in the increase in the value-added tax. Wouldn't that mean that the government is going to again spend more money on the reduction in value-added tax, which would then mean the shop owner has to spend more money in the accounting for value-added tax, which then means that has to be transferred to me as the consumer? Tell me, as your constituent, what is the benefit in that for me?
Well, when cost is high, it's just to put it simply, we have a dynamic economic team that have looked into this, and this includes our private citizens, right? So we can give them credit for also being involved. And because the deputy leader is an economic mind, mm-hmm. very successful Bahamian, and he spelled it out how it's going to be done. Because when you ease the burden and people are able to do more, they're more excited about spending.
Mm-hmm.
Their concern isn't holding on to that last dollar because they know that the majority of it is going to go to taxes and they don't know where the next dollar is going to come from to satisfy the essentials. And so I encourage you to look at that. The mm-hmm. thing is, value-added tax was increased with no plan. We never knew the plan to increase value-added tax. It certainly wasn't a promise. It was the opposite of what this government promised to the people, which was to get rid of value-added tax because they were against it.
Mm-hmm.
And they surprised even some persons who were part of their team. And that's why those persons would have voted against it, saying that I never told my constituents that we are going to increase value-added taxes on them.
Mm-hmm.
And we can take all of the quotes from the prime minister, this present prime minister, that he would have made concerning VAT and how he was against it, how it was lazy, how you do it when you don't think or can't think. And therefore, I guess he has answered the question as to why value-added tax was increased the way it was, because there was no plan and there was no thinking involved, in my opinion, in doing it that way. It certainly didn't benefit them. They did not hit the targets.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why it's important to come with a plan when you come to office.
Mm.
The PLP has a plan. Mm-hmm. We have presented a plan. It's been vetted by, I think, yourself and your fellow journalists to a large extent, and to satisfaction that this, if it can be done, it will get us out of the state that we are in. And we are in dire straits here. We have to rescue this country because we cannot go on magic. And that's why we present it in a document that's digestible, readable. We have a blueprint that's going to be released this week. And we know definitely the combination of visionary leadership, an excellent team, and planning.
Mm-hmm.
That's the formula for excellence. And our country's progressive, futuristic plans will be put in place by a progressive and futuristic government.
What can the people of Yamacore expect from a Zane Lightbourne as a representative?
They can expect honesty. They can expect presence. They can expect work. I represent working people for all of my career, more than 22 years in education and the union at very different capacities. And my record speaks for itself. But I tell you, there are 5 points that I have in my plan for Yamacore that addresses our community efforts, infrastructural improvements, improvements of parks for healthy living. It addresses education and all of these things that would be a part of a progressive community, job skills and creations. And this is the involvement of the entire community. And this is input from the entire community that has caused this plan to be put forward, accepted by the party, and then generated by me for our constituents to look at. We have presented it online, Yamacore, Hello Yamacore, also plp.org, and persons can reach us on any social media page or check in with the office that's located right there where Ms. Melanie Griffinato office
mm-hmm.
on Antigua Street in Elizabeth Estates.
Mm-hmm.
I am ready to answer any question from the residents. And I am present there. I don't visit Yamacore. I'm a part of Yamacore.
Give them your social media contacts again for me, Mr. Lightbourne, as well as your phone contacts in the event they want to reach out to you and find out more about who Zane Lightbourne is and what the campaign is all about.
Hello, Yamacore. Lightbourne is the handle. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. You can also, we have WhatsApp groups that a lot of our members are a part of. You can go on plp.org, and also 427-8333 is a number that you can contact me.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Lightbourne.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best, and I guess I'm rooting for you down there in Yamacore.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the opportunity, support, and the time. PLP all the way.
No problem. I appreciate that. I always liked that slogan, PLP all the way. I don't know whose idea it was to come up with that one. But I think that that have to be the best political slogan ever created in the history of all political slogans, as a matter of fact. So that was Zain Lightbourne. He is the candidate for Yamacraw. He's running down there against, I think it is going to be Ellsworth Johnson. And he says he's going to be present. He represents working people. He has done so for 22 years, and it's what has been the thing that has colored his life. So if you want someone that understands working people, that doesn't just visit Yamacraw, but that is from Yamacraw, then Zain Lightbourne is the guy you want. I want to end with this text message. It says, Kyle Cullman's statement is not worthy of a response. He needs to learn how to formulate proper sentences so that we can comprehend what he is saying. He should go and sit small. Anyway, that's my time. That's my music. I'm Leyvon Miller. It's Guardian Radio. The station for fresh news and smart talk. Don't move. They've got news. It's now.